Now, let's consider an example to analyze the similar situation. It is saying a clock with a metal pendulum is 5 seconds fast each day at temperature 15 degrees centigrade and 10 seconds slow each day at temperature 30 degrees centigrade. We are required to find coefficient of linear expansion of metal. In this situation, we can use the relation which we have just now studied, that is time lost or gained by a clock. Mainly we are talking about a pendulum clock. Per second is, this is written as delta t, which is half alpha delta t, where delta t is the variation in temperature. In this situation, we are not given with the graduation temperature of the clock at which it gives correct time. So, let us consider, let the graduation temperature of the clock pendulum is T naught. Then we can write the time lost or gained per second or per day even by multiplying this expression by the number of seconds in a day. So, we can write, let graduation temperature of pendulum as T naught, then the time lost or gained by clock per day will be, this we write, delta T is equals to half alpha delta T. Delta T is the difference of temperature with T naught multiplied by 6400. Which is the number of seconds in a day. So, as per the given conditions, we can write, given that on a day, the clock is 5 seconds fast when temperature is 15 degrees centigrade. So, we can write in this situation, 5 is equals to half alpha T naught minus 15, because certainly if it is fast, then the temperature must be lower, multiplied by 86400. And similarly, on some other day when temperature is 30 degrees centigrade, it is 10 seconds slow. So, we can write 10 is equals to half alpha 30 minus T naught multiplied by 86400. Now, say if this are equation 1, this are equation 2, we can directly divide the two equations and get the relation between T naught and alpha. So, if you divide this, alpha gets cancelled out. 1 by 2 will give you 1 by 2 is equals to T naught minus 15 upon 30 minus T naught. On solving, we'll get T naught is equals to 20 degrees centigrade. Now, from this equation 1, if you substitute T naught is equals to 20 degrees centigrade, this will give us 5 is equals to half alpha multiplied by 20 minus 15 is 5 multiplied by 86400. That will give us the value of alpha to be equals to 2 by 86400. That is equals to 2.31 into 10 to power minus 5. Per degree centigrade, that is the answer to this problem.